blessed us with this new year during the time of new year service with a promise, Psalm 62 verse 6. And also the Lord has given us the focus for this year. This is the promise: He only is my rock and my salvation, is my defense, I shall not be moved. Psalm 62:6. And also the Lord insisted that He is our rock. Amen. And also the Lord has given us the focus for this year 2020, to stand firm on the rock. Then 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 4 says that rock was Christ. Amen. That rock is Christ. The promises is our rock, so we will not be moved. The focus is we need to stand firm on the rock. Amen. Hallelujah. This year, we are going to hold on to the promise, and we are going to ask the Lord to give us the grace to stand firm on the rock. Amen. On that day of New Year's service, I spoke about the blessings when we keep the Lord as our rock. Just I want to recall those 3 points. The first blessing: we will not be moved. When we keep the Lord as our rock, we will not be moved. The second blessing: that rock will exalt us, or the rock will lift us. When you keep the Lord as your rock, He will keep you upon the rock above height. Amen. Hallelujah. It's above all the pressure, all the problems. The Lord will set your feet upon the rock. That means the rock will lift you up. You will not go under the things, but you will go above the things, because the rock will lift you. Amen. The third blessing, we saw that rock will reveal His presence to us. The rock will reveal Himself to us. Amen. Jesus is the rock. Hallelujah. And also Bible says the Lord kept a rock for Moses to come and stand. When Moses stood on the rock, the Lord revealed Himself to Moses. Amen. Hallelujah. Moses knew the Lord in the fresh way. Amen. Moses saw the glory of God when he stood up on the rock. So this 3 blessings we meditated on the watch night service. Today I'm going to continue the blessing when you keep the Lord as your rock. Amen. Hallelujah. Psalm 62:6 says, He is only my rock. Amen. We can read 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4.
And all drank the same spiritual drink. Mm. For they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ.
Amen. Hallelujah. Bible says they all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, that rock was Christ. This scripture says the rock was going with them all the way of their journey. Amen. The rock did not depart them. Amen. Because that rock was going along with them, the rock was giving water to His people whenever they are going through time of drought or time of thirsty. The rock was always there to give them some water. Amen. Hallelujah. Here the Bible says they drank spiritual drink. Amen. Actually, that time they drank literal water. But during the time of New Testament, the Lord was giving a revelation to Paul about that drink which they drank. Amen. It's not only the literal water, and also there was some spiritual blessing in that water. Amen. Hallelujah. Why the rock wants to go along with us? Not only to give the material blessing or physical blessings, but the Lord wants to give us spiritual blessings throughout this year 2020. Amen. How many of you need it? Hallelujah. Bible says, seek the Lord and His kingdom first, then everything will be added. Hallelujah. I think couple of weeks before I preached somewhere, you know, I do not remember whether here or Las Vegas. When you are walking with God, or when the rock is going along with you, you don't need to ask him, Lord, give me this, give me that. When the shepherd is going before you, you don't need to ask the shepherd, give me water, give me some food. I think I preached here only, right? Hallelujah. I hope you won't remember it. Amen. Because Bible says, shepherd knows how to take care of you. Amen. Shepherd knows sheep has to eat. Sheep has to drink. Amen. Hallelujah. Whether your children are asking for food or not, every parents will give the food at the right time. Yes or no? Amen. Amen. Sometimes the children will ask for extra snacks. Right? But if they are not asking also, the parents will take care of the kids. Amen. The shepherd knows what the sheep needs. Amen. So I believe that we don't need to ask for physical material blessing. Amen. But nothing wrong to ask also, because he's our father. Amen. So we need to be balanced. Amen. Nothing wrong to ask. If you are not asking also, he will take care of it. Amen. Some people, they will go in the other extreme. Oh, I won't ask anything. Right? So what these people will do, if someone asks, they will look them little lower. Hey, why you guys are asking for this? Right? Amen. The other people, they are going other extreme. Because you are not asking, nothing is happening to you. Right? So everybody faith is different. Yes or no? Right. Amen. But Bible is always asking us to be balanced. How many of you agree with me? Amen. You know, sometimes, you know, I won't ask for something, but it will come. I spoke about David's life. David did not ask for his kingdom position. Right? He asked the Lord, take me to the rock above, higher than I. Amen. Hallelujah. Because he went through a lot of pressure, he was asking the Lord to lift him up above all that problems. I think not even single place Bible recorded that David asked for kingdom. Amen. David asked for gold. David asked for silver. Nothing recorded like that. But everything came. Amen. Solomon asked for wisdom. But the Lord added everything. Hallelujah. What I'm trying to say is, I'm going to talk about the spiritual drink today. Amen. What the spiritual drink can do in our life. Why the rock wants to come along with us throughout our lifetime. Not only in 2020. Throughout our lifetime, the rock wants to go along with us. How many of you need this rock? Amen. You need to stand on the rock. You need to ask the Lord, Lord, today, thank you for coming along with me today. Amen. Whenever you feel tired, you can speak to the rock. The rock will give you the spiritual drink. Amen. That spiritual drink will do something in our life. That spiritual water will do something in our life. Amen. I'm going to talk to you about three different waters which came out of the rock and how the water blessed the people's life. Amen. Are you ready? Hallelujah. Okay. First one. You can turn to Psalm 78:14-15. Psalm 78 verse 14 and 15. These two scripture talks about the people of Israel, how they received the water.
In that daytime also, he led them with the cloud, and all the night with the light of fire. He split the rocks in the wilderness, and gave them drink in abundance like the depths.
Bible says the pillar of cloud, pillar of fire went along with them. Right? But the New Testament time, Paul says, the rock also went along with them. Amen. Pillar of cloud gave them some shade. Pillar of light gave them the light and the warmthness. The pillar of rock, this rock, gave them the water. Hallelujah. Bible says he gave them drink in abundance like the depths. He split the rocks in the wilderness. In the another verse it says, the water gushed out and it came like a river. Amen. It's not the water like coming by drop by drop, or it's not like a falls. It comes like a river. Amen. It's flooded so that everybody can have the spiritual drink. Amen. When the Lord gives something, it will be abundance. Amen. Hallelujah. The spiritual drink will be abundance. Amen. Hallelujah. And the Lord will give you what all you need. He alone can satisfy your soul with the spiritual drink. Amen. That's why the rock is coming along with these people. Now you can come. Exodus chapter 17 verse 1. Then I'm going to talk to you about the two experiences which the people of Israel experienced in the wilderness. Both experiences they went through. No water experience. Exodus 17:1.
Then all the congregation of the children of Israel set out on their journey from the wilderness of Sin, according to the commandment of the Lord, and camped in Rephidim. But there was no water for the people to drink.
A few weeks before I preached about this also, the Lord only took them to the place where there was no water. Amen. Hallelujah. Why God is taking his people to a place where they cannot see what they need. Sometimes the Lord will take us to the place where we cannot see anything. Amen. If the Lord wants to prepare the water before they go, he can do it. Because he set the pillar of cloud, he set the pillar of fire. Amen. It's easy for him to get ready some water. Yes or no?
Yes.
For him it's easy. If the Lord can give you pillar of fire, he can give the water also. Amen. Bible says the pillar of fire, that fire goes from earth to heaven. It was huge like that. It's not like a small fire which we can imagine. It was so huge. If the Lord can make a fire like that, it's easy for him to prepare the water. But why he took them to the place where they couldn't see any water? Amen. Many times when we are going through the spiritual dryness, today whenever I'm talking about the dryness, the drought, you need to connect with your spiritual life. Amen. Hallelujah. When we are going through spiritual dryness, the Lord will allow us to go through dryness so that we will know there is a rock. Amen. If there is no lackness, we will not look for the rock. We will not see the power of the rock in our life. It's good for us when we go through some dryness. Amen? How many of you agree with me? If there is no dryness, we will not seek God. If there is no problem, we will forget God after a while. Yes or no? Always dancing mode. Amen? Hallelujah. But when we go through some dryness, it will drive us to seek his face. Amen. Hallelujah. Because these people went through the scarcity of water, they failed to seek the rock, but they started to complain and murmuring. We can read the next verse.
Therefore the people contended with Moses and said, "Give us water that we may drink." So Moses said to them, "Why do you contend with me? Why do you tempt the Lord?"
Amen. Then Bible says Moses cried out to God. What can I do for these people? These people are doing like this. Amen. Hallelujah. But this morning the Lord wants to encourage us. Whenever you are going through dryness, remember there is a rock coming along with you. Amen. What you need to do, instead of crying out to Moses, crying out to the rock. Instead of complaining to Moses, call to the rock. Speak to the rock. Amen. We can read the verse 5 and 6. What the answer from God.
And the Lord said to Moses, "Go on before the people.
Go on before the people.
And take with you some of the elders of Israel.
Mm.
Also take in your hand your rod with which you struck the river and go.
Mm.
Behold, I will stand before you there on the rock in Horeb.
Amen. What the Lord said, I will stand before you there on the rock in Horeb, and you shall strike the rock, and water will come out of it that the people may drink. And Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel. The next verse says, the water gushed out. Okay. Behold, I will stand before you there on the rock in Horeb, and you shall strike the rock, and water will come out of it. That's why Paul said in the New Testament, that rock was Christ. Christ has to be striken out when we are going through the time of need. The need can be met out through the power of the rock. Amen. Bible says, I will stand before you on the rock. You need to strike. Hallelujah. Bible says that rock was Jesus. Jesus was beaten up. Jesus was striken up because of you and me. Amen. When Jesus was beaten up, Bible says the blood and water came out of Jesus. Amen. We can read Isaiah 53, verse 5, 6, 7. Isaiah 53, verse 5, 6, 7. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Verse 6. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Verse 7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, and yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. Amen. Jesus was standing on the rock. Jesus was beaten by the rod. Then the water came out. To whom the water came out? To the people, those who was complaining, murmuring against the power of God, against the guidance of God. Amen. Once we were also sinners, but Jesus was beaten up for you and me. When Jesus was beaten upon the cross, the Bible says, we can read John chapter, I think, 19:34. We can read John chapter 19, verse 34. Bible says, when that man pierced the side of Jesus, but one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and immediately blood and water came out. Amen. That blood and water came out of the body of Jesus Christ. Amen. To whom? To the people, those did lot of iniquity. That water and blood came out of for you and me. Because of that water and blood, today we are having the healing power inside of us. First, Jesus healed our soul. Our soul was wounded because of our own sins. Amen? But when the blood and water came out of that rock, it changed the life. Amen? The people, those murmured against the guidance of God, God gave the water to the same people. Amen? Today, Jesus is standing on the rock to release his spiritual water so that our life can be healed from all our sinful activities. Amen. Amen? Hallelujah. We need to remember, the rock is coming along with me to give my spiritual drink. Amen. When I have that spiritual drink, my life can be transformed. Hallelujah. That's why his side was pierced. Hallelujah. We can read some more verses from the same chapter. Exodus 19 verse 2. Bible says, by his stripes you will be healed. Amen. Hallelujah. And also Bible says, to have peace in our life, he was going through the path of suffering. He went through the cross so that you and can have a peace and healing. Amen. Exodus 19, 2.
Mm. For they had departed from Rephidim and came to the wilderness of Sinai.
Amen. Exodus 17, 1 says, they came to Rephidim. They went through the no water experience. But the Lord was standing on the rock and he released the water. After once they released the, received the water, it helped them to continue their journey. Amen. This year, the Lord wants you to continue a journey without any obstacles. Amen. Nothing should stop you. Amen. Hallelujah. The no water experience should not paralyze you in Rephidim. Rephidim is not your permanent place. It's a temporary so that you can see the power of the rock. In Rephidim, they saw the spiritual drink. They had the spiritual drink. It helped them to continue their journey. Hallelujah. You may go through time of drought, time of wilderness, but remember, the rock is going along with you. It will give you water. It will help you to continue your journey. Amen. Hallelujah. It's not the will of God to make you to stuck in one place. Amen. The Lord will help you to continue your journey. That's why he wants to release the water. Amen. Hallelujah. In the second place, they went through time of no water experience. We can see the Numbers chapter 20 verse 8. Numbers chapter 20 verse 8.
Take the rod, you and your brother Aaron, gather the congregation together. Speak to the rock before their eyes, and it shall yield its water. Thus you shall bring water for them out of the rock and give drink to the congregation and their animals.
Amen. Here the Lord is not asking Moses to strike the rock, but he said speak to the rock. Because Jesus can be striken only one time. Jesus can die for you and me only one time. Amen. He born and he died, he resurrected. Amen. There is no more born again or no more death again, no more resurrection. When he comes back, he's going to come as a King of Kings with full of glory. Amen. Hallelujah. So only one time Jesus went through the cross for you and me. No more cross for Jesus. Amen. How many of you agree with me? Jesus is not going to birth again. Jesus is not going to born again as a baby. Jesus is only one time. He has done everything on the cross. Hallelujah. That's why this time the Lord told, hereafter you need to strike the rock, you need to speak to the rock. Amen. Okay, we can read the verse, same chapter, Numbers chapter 20, verse 2 and 3. What this drink did the things to the people. Amen. Because they drank this water, what happened to them? Before they drink the water, what was their condition? If you read Numbers chapter 20, verse 2. Now there was no water for the congregation, so they gathered together against Moses and Aaron. And we can read the verse, next verse.
And the people contended with Moses and spoke, saying, if only we had died when our brethren died before the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. What was their condition before they drink the water? What they were telling? If only we had died when our brethren died before the Lord. That means they were regretting for something which did not happen to them. Amen. In our life also, whenever we are going through some drought or lackness, immediately we'll think, right? Many times I thought like this. Why Lord, why you took away from my mother's womb? Right? You never thought like that? Amen. Sometimes I thought, no? You all the angels. Amen. Many times I thought, why I born in this world? Why you gave me life? Why you did not take my life away from my mother's womb? Amen. Many times I regretted for many things in my life. I used to say like that. But one day then the Lord told me, don't say like that. Amen. Don't regret for the things which did not happen in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. One time, you know, during my 20s, in my 20s, I was going through some lot of challenges. You know, one time I told, because of something happened with my friend's circle, I told, it's better I can become a dumb like that. I don't want to speak to you all. Better I can be like a mute. You know, next day I couldn't talk. You won't believe it. Next day I couldn't talk. I'm trying to speak out, but the words are not coming out. It happened one time, only one time. Amen? Because I regretted, I complained. Amen? The same way it happened to Indra also. One time she went through a lot of pressure. She said, it's better I can be admitted in the hospital. Like that she said. The next day she got the tummy pain. She had to admit it. Then she had to go through the appendix surgery. It happened. We both are the testimony.
Amen.
Amen. We should not complain, regret. Many times we are going through time of regrets in our life. Yes or no? Amen. Long time before I thought like this, why am I born in this family? Long time before, not now. Amen. I came through all these things. Amen. Definitely sometimes you are also going through time of regrets. Why I chose this job? Why I chose this option? Why I chose this decision? Why I took this step? Yes or no? Amen? For a long time I was thinking, why I joined the teacher's training college? Why I became teacher? Long time I was thinking like that. I was regretting for that. But later on I realized that teacher job is helping me a lot.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. And also I regretted for the 11th grade, 12th grade, you know. They gave me the science group admission. But my father forced me to take the commerce and accounts. I regretted for that one for a long time. Many times I was thinking, if I took the science group, maybe this time I would be a doctor. But now I'm a spiritual doctor.
Amen.
Amen? Amen? You can become a spiritual doctor by studying commerce group. And also the accounts, it's helping me a lot now.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Are you okay?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Okay.
Amen?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The reason I'm saying, we are going through time of regrets. But when you drink the spiritual drink, it will take away every regrets from your life.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes we will regret that things happened 20 years before. Still we regret. Amen. But thank God, by God's grace, now no regrets in my life.
Amen.
Amen. I came through it. The Lord helped me to overcome all those things. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we need to drink the spiritual drink. It will take away all the regrets from our life. These people thought it's better for us if we would have died with our brethren. Amen. If the Lord wants to take you, it's easy for him. But there is a purpose and reason the Lord is making you to exist in this world. Yes or no?
Yes.
How many times you went through sickness? How many times you went through accidents? Amen.
Amen.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Amen. Over the night, 37 years old, recently I heard at 37 years old, had a heart attack and died. 37 years old. If the Lord wants to take your life, it's easy for him. But if the Lord keep you alive, there is a purpose in it.
Amen.
So today we need to make a decision, no more regrets.
Amen.
No regrets in my life. If the regrets needs to go, you need to drink the spiritual drink. Amen? That's why the rock is going along with you. We can read next verse. Verse, I think, 4. Mm.
And the people contended with Moses and spoke, saying, if only you died when your brother died before the Lord, why have you brought up the assembly of the Lord into this wilderness, that we and our animals should die here?
Amen? They regretted about their past. They did not have hope about their future. They came to a conclusion that you brought us here to die, but not to kill you, but but to give you life and abundant life. Amen. Bible says the thief comes to steal, kill and destroy. But I come to give you life and abundant life. Amen. They regretted for the things which happened in their life. They did not have a hope about their future also. Many times, you know, we are not having hope in Jesus Christ. We are not having hope in the Lord. Why the Lord is taking me through this path? The Lord took them through the wilderness to take them to the promised land. Amen. During this time of transition is from Egypt to Canaan. During this time of transition, we are regretting and we are losing our hope. But the Lord wants to give us hope throughout this year to give us life. Amen. How many of you believe that? Hallelujah. These people spoke against their hope also. These people spoke against their future. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor not to kill, but to give you life. Amen. Tell the neighbor, the Lord will give you long life. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, somebody will come and tell, Pastor, I am very scared whether I will die. I'll tell, don't worry, you will live 90 years. Go with peace. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes or no? The Lord will give you spiritual life. You will have a life in your spirit. Amen. Chapter 20, verse 5. Mm.
And why have you made us come up out of Egypt to bring us to this evil place?
Then what they said? Evil place. Amen. They regretted about their past. They did not have a hope about their future. Then they can complain about their present. Amen. Hallelujah. Right, amen. We will present or past or future or nothing good. Amen. That's why the rock is coming along with you to show you that I have a hope and plans for you, according Jeremiah 29:11. Amen. Do not remember your past. Do not regret about anything. And also, the Lord wants to tell you, this is not an evil place, it's a good place. If the rock is there, how the place can become an evil place? How many of you believe that? Amen. If the Lord dwells in your house, how your house can become an evil? Amen. If the Lord dwells inside of your life, how your life can become an evil life? How many of you believe that the Lord is with you now? Amen. How many of you believe that according to the will of God, you are here right now? Then this place is a good place. Where you are now, it's a good place. What kind of path you are going through now, it's a good place. Because the rock is coming along with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Maybe you missed something in the past, but God can turn every evil into good. God can change your evil into good. Don't say this is an evil place. It's a good place. Because the rock is coming along with you. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why we need to have the spiritual drink. We can read chapter 20, verse 11.
Mm. And then Moses lifted his hand and struck the rock twice with his rod, and water came out abundantly, and the congregation and their animals drank.
Amen. Hallelujah. God showed his mighty power one more time to these people, those who are going through regretness, hopelessness, and complaint. Amen. The Lord wants to show his mighty power through his mighty hand. Amen. We will see the power of God. It comes out of the rock. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. The last water, the third water, wants to change our life completely. Amen. It's a life-changing water, living water. John chapter 4, verse 10. We are going to finish with a couple of verses. John chapter 4, verse 10. In all the places, it changed the life of people. First place, it brought a healing. The second place, it changed the mentality of the people, their thinking, because they saw the power of God through the rock. Amen. The John chapter 4:10, Jesus answered and said to that Samaritan woman, if you knew the gift of God and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. Jesus spoke this word. Jesus wants to give us living water. Living water means no end for that water. That water will keep on flow from the rock. Amen. The rock is Jesus Christ. If you can read 4:14.
The woman said to him, Sir, you have nothing to draw with and the well is deep. Where then do you get that living water?
Amen. She was asking from where you can have this water. Amen. Because Jesus said, I will give you the living water. Amen. Then Jesus told, verse 15.
The woman said to him, Sir, give me this water that I may not thirst nor come here
to draw. After Jesus told that I will keep the fountain inside of you and that water will keep on springing out and it will come out and you can have the water. Immediately she asked, Lord, give me that water. Hallelujah. See, when she heard about the living water, immediately the thirst came from her heart. I need that water. Amen. Today the spiritual rock, it's going along with us. That rock is ready to give the spiritual drink to every one of us. But the Lord is expecting the thirst from you and me. When the Lord says, I will give you living water, we need to say, Lord, I need that water. Amen. As soon as the Samaritan woman heard about the living water, her response was, I need that water. Amen. Bible says, whoever hunger and thirst, they will be filled. Amen. When you have a hunger and thirst upon the righteousness, you will be filled. That woman was asking the Lord, I need that water. Today we need to make a decision. Lord, I need that water every day. Every day. Refreshing water. It's a living water. It's a life-changing water. It's a mind-changing water. It's a healing-bringing water. Amen. Hallelujah. Then Jesus told her, if you need the water, verse 16.
Jesus said to her, go call your husband and come here.
If you need water, if you need this living water, you need to do something. Amen. What you need to say, what you need to do, go call your husband and come here. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus started to deal with the Samaritan woman with her personal things, what was going through in her life. Jesus knew where there was a problem. Jesus knew what is stopping her to get the living water. Amen. How many of you need the living water? Amen. We don't need to pay a price. We don't need to pay money. But we need to pay a price. Amen. If you need the living water, we need to correct ourselves where we are missing. The Samaritan woman missed in that area. Right? I don't want to go into details because we all know the incident of a Samaritan woman, or you can read, go home and read John chapter 4. We do not have time. That area was the problem for the Samaritan woman. But she wants to get the living water. Jesus also ready to give the living water. But she had to do something. She had to set it right before the Lord. Amen. The rock is going along with us to give us water. The rock is ready to give the water. But before we get the living water, we need to set it right certain things in this year 2020. Amen. We need to remember he is ready, he is willing. But he wants to deal with us in certain areas. If you do not bring your husband, you cannot get the water. Amen? Hallelujah. Jesus did not put her into shame. Jesus did not try to put her into shame. Jesus did not try to offend her. But Jesus tried to help her to sort out her problem. Immediately she told, Lord, I do not have a husband. than Jesus told, you told the truth. Amen. Jesus did not tell her, because you are not having husband, I am not going to give her water. Because the purpose of Jesus told like this to set it right things. Later on, she went and told the people, come and see, maybe he is Christ. Amen. He told whatever I had done. Amen. She confessed. Bible says because of her words, many people came to know Jesus. Hallelujah. When our life is set it right, we will get the water, and also we'll get the living water inside the fountain. It will flow to the other people. Amen. That's why today the Lord is coming along with us. Hallelujah. Wherever we missed, we need to bring that area to Jesus. We need to tell the Lord, Lord, this is the problem for me. This is the one stopping me from getting the living water. Amen. For everyone, that's a problem is different. Everyone, that the area is different. Everyone, the challenge is different. But we need to check in which area Jesus wants to deal with me today. Jesus is ready to give the living water, but before that, he wants to deal with me in certain areas.